trackpad is popping up!
What's up, guys? Welcome back. I'm Grant Thompson, the King of Random.
And I'm Ijustine.
And today we're here to answer a question from the comments from EddieG098, who wants to know, would you damage a laptop if you spilled liquid nitrogen on the keyboard? So Eddie, we're doing this experiment today for you.
This is for you, Eddie. So this is a Chromebook. It is an Acer. We got this on Amazon Prime now, and it arrived at my place in 15 minutes when we decided to do this.
Amazing service, unbelievable, and I can't believe, I'm jealous. I don't have internet that fast.
But this is gonna be exciting, so we're basically gonna make a Chromebook cake in this cake pan.
Yes, we found a cake pan that is the perfect size for our Chromebook. It just fits very nicely in here. We got Eddie's comment sitting down there at the bottom.
And it fits perfectly in this cake pan.
And random cake pan, look at that. The dimensions are absolutely perfect. There's like maybe a quarter inch gap on the front and back there. It was like it was meant to be.
It was.
Okay, I think it's go time.
I think so. What do we do now?
So let's get you over here. I've got this thermos that we've already pre-filled with liquid nitrogen. We've set this laptop in a cake pan, and that's so that we can keep as much of the nitrogen around the keyboard as we can. So I thought it'd be fun. Let's go ahead and play a video of liquid nitrogen while we pour liquid nitrogen on the computer itself.
So fitting.
Even a viable idea, because I don't want to waste new technology unnecessarily.
All right. So we got our video playing right now. We've got our thermos full of liquid nitrogen. It's time to pour it on the keyboard and just see exactly how it reacts. So you want to do the honors?
Yeah, I don't have my gloves on though. Is that bad?
I don't think you need gloves.
Okay.
I think you're good.
Should I just pour right in the middle?
Your hands are insured, right? Nicely done. So what we see immediately is you see all the nitrogen skittle across, and it's kind of collected in the bottom here. And what's happening is it's boiling off, but at the same time it's cooling everything down. Is the video still playing?
Yeah.
Looks like it is. All right, well I say, let's go ahead and add some more.
Oh yeah, that's what I say.
I heard some cracking. We got Leidenfrost effect happening on the trackpad right now. It was bouncing around like a game of Pong. Try a little bit more right there. It was kind of fun how that was. It's like a little hockey rink. Yeah, look at that right there.
Oh!
Boing.
I think I saw a little flicker on the screen. Oh no, that was you. That's the video.
I think some of this nitrogen is flowing down inside the keyboard, but look, the screen is actually still playing. That's kind of cool.
Shall we put some more?
It's a video of a phone and a phone and a phone and a phone and a phone.
In a laptop.
Phoneception. Oh, I called it. This is looking pretty frosty. You can see how it's changing color. See how the buttons used to be black and now they're looking a little bit faded? Oh.
Wow, look at that.
Well, let's toss in some more.
Yes.
Let's go ahead and fill her up. Let's submerge that thing. Oh, something just happened. It froze.
Oh, I heard some things.
It's still going.
It's still going.
All right, let's keep it running.
Here you go, Eddie.
Right on the trackpad, maybe.
Oh, baby! Trackpad is popping up!
The trackpad just busted right up off the computer here. Look at this. It's just peeled right off. It's peeling itself off. Have you ever wondered what a trackpad looks like underneath? Because there it is. This was just an adhesive. You feel that it's sticky?
Wow.
This is like a giant sticker. So we'll just like set that off to the side.
Yeah.
But the video is still playing. And
the mouse, it's working.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, look, the cursor's right there.
You're right. It's still working, even with my gloves on.
Wow.
That's kind of fun. All right, so.
Did you say we need more liquid nitrogen? This is, oh,
it looks to me.
Screen just went black.
Did it? Uh-oh. Can we bring it back?
I think that might be the end lappy top.
Let's go ahead and throw the rest of it in anyway. Let's go ahead and freeze this thing completely solid and then see when it warms back up if we can get it to restore. This looks so cool. It's completely submerged right now.
Should I keep pouring
more?
Yeah,
pour it all in. Pour it all in. That is beautiful. So here we are, guys. It's been about 5 minutes. Our computer's been sitting in the liquid nitrogen. I think it lasted about like a minute and a half before the screen went off. What's really interesting is the screen has bent. It's actually warped and gone concave. And it's so cold right now, we can't even close it. That might even be because the screen is warped.
Eddie's comment.
Eddie's comment is soaked right through. Look at that. You can see it dries off pretty quickly, though. There's actually nitrogen inside the keyboard. Look at that.
Wow.
If I shake it, I can get it to drip out.
Yeah, look, it's all dripping right there.
And my hands are freezing. And
what
the buttons
was that?
Are falling off. Oh, you know what that was? The little bottom.
Oh, that's not important.
Whatever those are, the little support tabs or support buttons. Those are frozen off. This is really cold. Do you want to try holding that for a second?
Yeah, is it going to be cold?
Does that feel cold?
Yeah, it feels cold.
Yeah, that's cool, huh?
Oh, gosh.
That's amazing. That's frosty. So, guys, our computer is legitimately frozen. I mean, how cold is that?
I mean, it's frozen.
It's cold enough that we're gathering frost on the bottom here. Can you see that?
Yeah. This is like Elsa's laptop.
Elsa's laptop. That's right. Should I let it go?
Let it go.
There you go. What I really want to know is, at what point in time could we turn it back on?
Like, do you think the laptop turned itself off? Or do you think it just stopped working?
It's hard to say. The buttons don't work. Feel those. Those are frozen solid as well.
Man, liquid nitrogen is cool.
I see what you did there. So Eddie, in answer to your question, even at this point, would liquid nitrogen damage a laptop?
Yeah, this definitely is damaged.
I'd call this very damaged. The question now becomes, will it survive? Can we resurrect the laptop? Can we bring it back to life? Because even after 5 minutes now, I can start seeing the warping, ironing itself out. I think probably we could even lay the sticker back on the trackpad here, maybe? Who knows? I guess we're gonna find out. We're gonna give this about 25 minutes to set so it can warm back up to room temperature. Press the power button and see what happens. Guys, we're back. It's been about 25 minutes now, and this computer looks like it's had about enough time to thaw out. You can even see all the moisture from the air, all that frost has now condensed and turned into water.
Look at this.
Which I think the water is probably more dangerous than the liquid nitrogen was. But the other thing I'm noticing is the screen has almost shifted back to normal. We can press that back into place.
Oh, look at that.
Click, click, click. And so yeah, let's just take a second now. Let's take some paper towel, clean this all up, and then we'll hit the power button and see if it actually still works. I've also salvaged this little sticker that came from the trackpad. And now that it's unfrozen, now that it's thawed out, I think we can actually stick it back in place. So we'll put that right on there. So, should we plug it in?
I don't know.
Is it safe to plug in?
Probably not.
Well, safety is not my middle name. Okay, moment of truth. Let's see if it'll turn on. Oh my goodness, check this out. Something just popped up. Chrome OS system is missing or damaged. Please insert a recovery USB.
It probably just damaged the hard drive.
Interesting. So if we ran some kind of recovery system, it looks like theoretically this would work. The LCD screen is back.
The screen looks perfect.
Screen looks great, yeah. Let's see, now that it's warmed up though, can we close it? Yeah, the hinges work, okay. So that's thawed back out.
This is pretty durable. I'm quite impressed actually.
So if we give this a few more minutes to thaw out, perhaps we can get this thing to boot up again. Guys, you're not gonna believe this. We just downloaded, put some information on an SD card and reformatted the computer and look at this. We are back in business. I mean, it's kind of hard to tell right now because the screen is black, but if we bring up a program like YouTube, let's go back to Chrome here. You can see the mouse works, the trackpad works perfectly, and we can bring up my liquid nitrogen video.
Got like a triple flash there, the camera just turned off.
Wow.
I can't tell if the camera turned itself off just because it had a low battery warning.
So the only problem we really had with this computer was the sticker for the trackpad peeled off, and once it warmed up, we just glued it back together, restarted the computer, reformatted it, and everything is working perfectly. So, will liquid nitrogen damage a computer after all?
I think it damages it a little bit. I mean, I'm sure the internals of this thing, something bad has happened, but it's still working.
Obviously not an experiment we want to recommend that you try, but it's very amazing to see how resilient and how robust even a computer on the price point of this one,
like yeah,
how it swings back.
$170.
Very crazy.
Can you believe that? That's less than a phone.
So I think what we need to do is give this thing away.
Yeah, we could sign it.
We should sign it and give it away. That's a great idea. All you have to do is go down to our link in the description to follow us on Instagram. Follow iJustine and the King of Random on Instagram, and then look for one of our pictures from our collaboration and leave us a comment using this emoji. Comment that emoji, we're gonna surf through it, we're gonna pick one of you randomly to get our liquid nitrogen frozen Chromebook that apparently still works as good as new.
I can't believe it.
So there you have it, guys. You asked us to pour liquid nitrogen on a keyboard, and that's exactly what we did.
We did, and not only did we pour it onto a keyboard, but an entire laptop.
And big thanks to EddieG098 for requesting this experiment. You can go ahead and check your YouTube inbox, Eddie. I'm sending you 25 bucks.
Oh, that's nice. Oh, Eddie, you get a present.
And a huge thanks to iJustine for letting us terrorize her in our kitchen today. Thank you so much for your space.
Hey, thanks for giving me some liquid nitrogen and the courage to light myself on fire.
And we just filmed something epic in her backyard that you won't want to miss. I'll put a link down in the description that'll take you over to her channel. Go like, subscribe, follow iJustine. She's amazing. And thank you for joining us for this experiment. We'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then.
Bye. Eddie's gonna go shopping. I'm just like hanging out so far away from you because I'm just scared of what's gonna happen.
Hey guys, I wanted to jump back in for just a second to invite you to come follow me on Instagram. I've got a very active page where I post daily pictures and stories of behind the scenes and every day is an adventure. Just take 5 seconds right now to click the link in the description to come follow me on Instagram at thekingofrandom, and I'll see you there.